What or who inspired you to pursue a career in science?
I was always interested in scientific things. I remember at primary school watching a television programme as a class. We watched a series about sort of biomedicine and history of medicine, and I remember finding that absolutely fascinating. So I'd always had that interest in logical thinking, you know, tied to sort of health and medicine. And then I like solving puzzles. So again, lots of things to be solved in science. In reality, I just kept doing, in terms of choosing subjects or work or choices, I just kept doing what I most enjoyed and found out, and this is where it led me.
How important are role models for career development in science, especially for women?
You can't become what you don't see. So if you don't see somebody like you doing something that you actually would be very good at, you perhaps never even consider it. So for me, role models are important for that reason. And then the other thing that I think is really important about role models is that it's the next person up. It's the next step up for you. So again, it's someone like you, but it's also someone that's had a similar journey, and you can think, I can reach where they are now. It's just the next step for me, rather than looking 10 steps ahead, which is much more challenging. So role models, for two reasons, very important.
How did the Athena Swan Gold Award impact research culture in your department?
I think it's had a tremendous impact. We've been engaging for over a decade now, and I can really see the change in the culture of the department. It was when we found our vision of simply good practice, making sure that everything we did was the best it could be, whatever it was, whether it was our science or the way we did seminars or how we hosted things, just making sure everything was excellent meant that we just created a culture that cared about people and that enabled them to thrive and do their best, which meant they were doing their best science and, what's more, enjoying it at the same time.
What changes can universities and research organisations make to ensure everyone has an equal shot at success?
So I think for an organisation or a university, you have to look at those who aren't there and see who you're missing. So at least you can make sure that you work out how to bring the people who are missing from your organisation in. Because if you're missing people, you're missing talent, you're missing different views, you're missing a gap in knowledge or a way of tackling something. When you've got people, again, you need to look at people who are thriving and people who are struggling more, and then put in initiatives that make sure, again, that you're enabling everybody to thrive. Because at the end of the day, you know, what we're facing with are difficult questions, real global challenges, and we need all the talent that's out there to help solve those, and that's what an institute or a university should really be striving to do.